What's going on, everybody? My name's Chris, and welcome back to the second episode of Let's Play SpongeBob SquarePants, the movie video game. Look at all this chocolate. I just want to eat it. Nom 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 no. We start off the second episode with the first death of the game that I did on purpose. But still, you can destroy this thing. So in the last episode, we start off our manly adventure. But then SpongeBob did not get a manager promotion. Look at all these crab patties. And thus started the depression of SpongeBob. And now he's stuck in here somewhere and we have to go save SpongeBob. The swing on the ice block, press Y. That's right. Yeah, somehow my tongue gets stuck all the way out there. But wait! You might be wondering, what's down here, Chris? Well, I wondered that too my first playthrough this game. And I came down here. And there's something! Oh, there's weights. I thought there would be something else in here. Whoa, what the? Alrighty then, I'll take it. Popcorn! I want some popcorn. Om nom. I really like all the, like, destroyable objects in this game. There's so many things to destroy! It's so fun! I guess it's some kind of weird kitchen. Oh no, the store is closed. But I'll destroy it with my manly starfish arms. Hey, treasure! Indeed, let's take a look at what this is. Mermaid Man SpongeBob. So you can turn on and off costumes. This is the second kind of extra in the game. You could get... Oh, I'm surprised I was able to make that. you could get costume changes, which is pretty great. I notice sometimes I don't always work. So we'll have to see if that does work. Oh, I guess jellyfish always do give you 5 shiny objects. I mean, wait. Get another combo there. I didn't realize that. I think it started with a P, though. I love rooms like these. They're just so fun-looking. Not really fun, like, but they look really cool. All the cherries and lollipops just kind of hanging out in here. Oh boy, here we go. What do you have to say?
Patrick?
Oh!
If you bring me more Goofy Goober tokens, I can grant you the cartwheel move.
I want the cartwheel move!
Oh boy, I love whatever that move is.
He just goes back to his stupid default face. Alright. Whoa, and I got teleported. So, yeah, there's upgrades in this game you have to actually buy, which is a lot more interesting compared to when they just gave it to you in Battle for Bikini Bottom. Yeah, unless you guys have seen the movie, some of this game might be confusing, at least the storyline. I mean, you don't have to watch it to, like, understand what's going on in the game. But first, like, story-wise, it might make sense if you had seen the movie before, and okay, interesting. Whoa, what is this? What? Is my ignorance actually working? My fake ignorance? It's not. Defeat all the enemies! Wave 1 of 3. Are you ready, kids? Set, go! That's not what the line is. And you see, I'm wearing my Mermaid Man costume. And what? These are not the guys! What is going on? I think these guys all just kill each other. Okay, that was easy. Okay, so this is one of the first enemy variations of the guys we already saw. Okay, they're just all kind of killing each other. I'm okay with this. The guys that puke breath out of you. Yeah, these are very clearly. Whoa, I did not see you. These are very clearly them. Whenever you do get hit, they actually stop laughing at you, which is actually pretty great because it gives you a chance to recover. 40 left. And this is one of the first mini games in this game that you get prizes from. I very highly suggest you do these because they're useful for getting Goofy Goober tokens, but they are not 100%. Or they're not needed to 100% the game. Actually, I guess that's not true, but they're not needed to beat the game, I guess, is what I should say. Yeah, you keep taunting me, you butthead. I guess my attack is stronger because it took 2 hits to kill the hammer guy before, now it's only taking 1. Huh. That's good to know. Okay, don't you dare puke at me. So this first one is actually pretty easy. These get a lot more difficult in the game. When I practiced this game a few months ago, I didn't get up to the point where they do get difficult, but I remember getting really frustrated at these as a kid, so yeah. But I do really like these, like, kill all the enemies thing, this, like, tournament kind of thing. I love this in games. I think it's really fun. Destroy a whole bunch of, like, enemies like this. Although it does get kind of repetitive after a while, especially when you die a lot. Makes me really for look at all these freaking like weird robots in the sky that look kind of like plankton, I guess, with big lips and a giant red eye. And things get shot from the nose apparently. And if you hadn't noticed already, which I don't know how you wouldn't have, but in the top right, there's how many they tell you how many enemies are left to kill. I mean, I know it's pretty crazy, isn't it? All right, we're almost finished with this. So it is definitely weird how they put you a SpongeBob with these ones. I believe all the mini games are actually SpongeBob. I think, as far as I remember, I could be wrong, but I think even if it's a Patrick oriented level, I think all these just make you play as SpongeBob for some reason, whatever it is. I don't really understand it myself, really. For reals, Ace, don't you dare touch me! Yeah, what I really actually like about this game is when you hit an enemy when you hit enemies into each other, it does kill them. Same thing with how friendly fire is on, that's how I was talking about how they're killing each other earlier. Hoo-ah! Hoo-hee-haw! Karate chop all you assholes! Yeah, oh god! Yeah, these freaking hammers, if you go at them straight on, they are kind of hard to avoid sometimes. They're just at that, like, perfect range. Yeah, you suck at aiming, Mr. Sir. Alright. And all these go sploosh! Sploosh? There we go. They all splooshed. And getting a Goofy Goober token with my merman! Mermaid man. It's the merman! Or the merman. Yeah. Half the laugh came after the game, like, froze for a second there. And there's our second Goofy Goober token. So we get it. I guess we could learn cartwheel moves. Is that what Mindy was saying? The kids are confused. Mindy is from the movie as well. She's a movie exclusive character.
Okay, Patrick. Since you've brought me enough Goofy Goober tokens, you may now use the cartwheel move.
Oh my god, I'm so excited! And they give you this cool artwork every time you get something like this. It's pretty good.
Time to spin?
Well, I kind of already was spinning.
You
yeah.
Gotta get going, Patrick. There's lots to do.
Yep. Okay, so that... Oh, you need this. Oh, I didn't know that. Huh, maybe you do need the upgrades in the game. So, yep. I got a cartwheel move, which is really the best thing ever because it's pretty much a run button. we could destroy these. And we could actually destroy it with these. He's talking about he's ready to spin, but he already spins when he attacks. So it's like, what? Oh, I totally thought those gumdrops on the ground or whatever the heck they were. These green weights. Stupid music. It's pretty great. Alright. Oh no, I'm not getting the weights! I need the weights. I'm waiting for the part of the music where it sounds like they're saying, you bastard. Bastard. That's what they say. It's kind of hard to hear some of the like more quiet things. That glowing sound effect in this game is way too loud, and I hate that they made it so loud. I guess they made it loud so we could hear it from far away. Okay, hold on. Aw, now they're not even doing it anymore. God dang it, I missed the chance to show you guys the bastard. What? Something about girth? Okay there, Patrick. Settle down. Alright, let's go. So, I guess we could do this again if we really wanted to. Also, much like the SpongeBob SquarePants Battle for Bikini Bottom game, you do get the chance to teleport to whatever level you want or challenge. The ones that have like the Goofy Goober face on it, you have completed. The ones the ones without the face have started, but you haven't completed. And the question marks are just ones you haven't like even gotten near yet. And your stupid face for not getting near. How dare you? Gumballs! Oh my god! Oh, that must taste delicious. That must smell delicious. This big puffs of gumball sugar looks delicious to me. So yeah, the cartwheel move is pretty great. I love it. It's probably one of my favorite moves in the game, actually. But not that there's a lot to choose from, but you know what I'm saying, right, guys? All right, we're just gonna stand right below this weight. Just kidding. We're not gonna grab it. Okay, let's grab this Krabby Pate. Still took some damage. Look at this picture on the wall. It's just a peanut with a hat on it. It's like, what? It's not even Goofy Goober himself. It's just a peanut with a hat. Alright. Well, whatever. I guess we'll take that. Don't destroy these crates if you want a beloved. Oh, it's a 50 weight thing. And now you can destroy them all with your cartwheel move. And I don't even understand how it's in the air. Okay, whatever you say, game. whatever you say. And with that, see, we have another PowerPoint? Is that what that's called? See, this is where the tough decisions come in. I should probably start to get health already. I know you do play more missions as SpongeBob, so I'm gonna get that. Yeah, I guess so. And yeah, the artwork for these is pretty uncreative. They just show you four Krabby Patties, but yeah, one more Krabby Patty with extra manliness. Got you, SpongeBob. I'm repeating some of the lines of this game, just because they might be quiet to hear in comparison to the music. Actually, to be honest, I could probably turn down the music, can't I? Options. There we go. There we go. Okay, that's a bit better, I think. I think it kind of sounds like the music louder, but that must be some weird effect playing with my mind, because it can't be, right? Whoa. That's a cool looking roof. Whoa, there's like a tunnel over there. Can we climb that rope or something? Huh. No, we can't. Weird. I wonder what that's for. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Okay, it's for a later mission in the game, and by later I mean like one of the last missions in the game, and as far as I remember, the most difficult. I remember the guy I'm doing SpongeBob SquarePants Battle for Bikini Bottom race with. I love that echo sound effect, even if it kind of clips out and it gets all weird. But he said he had never completed that mission. That's one of the only missions he's never been able to complete in this game, and yeah, I understand why. It is really difficult, and I remember getting really, really angry at that as a kid, so it's a lot of things I get angry at in games. Frustration! Alright, let's get all these weights. I can't wait to get all the weights! Okay. But it's a good game, though, to be honest, when there's times where it's like, it's fun and it's really frustrating at some points. Because, you know, games are supposed to be difficult sometimes. Alright, let's go get all these weights. Oh, yeah, actually, you want to get rid of all these in one go, because I... Oh, no! How about I mess it up? Maybe you just have to get all of them? Maybe you don't have to get them all in one go? Oh, no, I might have messed it up. I'm pretty sure you get something if you get all those. Let's see if it even says anything. Silly. Oh, sorry, I was copying Mr. Krabs' noise there. I don't know if that might have peeked up on the microphone. I'm a silly goofy goober, yeah. Holy crap. Okay, I'll take it. Oh my good lord, it's a freaking ice cream tray! I want one in my room! Except for the fact that it would all melt and be all gross. It is like walking on ice cream, because you are walking on ice cream, you silly Patrick. Pretty sure I missed something in this room, actually, but we'll have to come back and get it. Unless I feel like reloading it, which I kind of don't. Uh-oh. Oh my god! Drama! Excitement! Fun! But this is kind of really easy. With these machines, actually, it's pretty easy to grind shiny objects in this game. Why? It even teleported me here, what? Just because... Or it's easy... Yeah. It's either the grind object of this game or weights just because of the fact that, you know, the duplicator trons. These guys give you so many when you, like, combo a whole bunch in a row. Bastard. Ooh, SpongeBob. I guess we can continue as different people. We can switch to SpongeBob! I completely forgot about this. Huh, I did not know you could switch, and it's kind of cool that they use the bathroom in this game like that. What's up here? Is that the beginning? Oh, that is the beginning of the level. Cool. What's this? Minnie must first grant SpongeBob the Sonic Wave Guitar ability before he may play the Sonic Wave Guitar challenge. This is the challenge that is, like, holy crap, like, impossible. I'm not looking forward to it at all. We're a bit off there, SpongeBob, but okay. Oh, boy. So happy.
There you are, Patrick. I've been trying to find you all evening.
It's 8 in the morning, SpongeBob.
Oh my god, 8 o'clock. I am late for work. Mr. Krabs is gonna kill me. Oh, Mr. Krabs.
Back at the Krusty Krab, King Neptune confronts Mr. Krabs about his alleged thievery.
Hey, there to use that screenshot.
He asks if there is anyone present who may vouch for Mr. Krabs' character. And our yellow knucklehead McSpazitron shows up to accuse Mr. Krabs of being a horrible person. King Neptune zaps Mr. Krabs, causing SpongeBob to sober up quickly. he selflessly volunteers to journey to Shell City and retrieve the king's crown. Freezing Mr. Krabs in place, King Neptune grants a 6-day reprieve so SpongeBob and Patrick may attempt to retrieve the crown. King Neptune's daughter Mindy provides SpongeBob and Patrick with a magic mirror through which she can communicate and assist
their silly duo.
We continue as SpongeBob and Patrick arrive at the paddy wagon.
Oh no. Oh no. And so it begins. Thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Let's Play SpongeBob SquarePants, the movie video game. What am I talking about? What am I talking about? So it begins.
It's time to start your journey. Drive the paddy wagon through the bottom to the edge of town.
Yeah. You guys will have to wait till next episode to see what the heck I'm talking about. Or after we finish this.
Don't let the paddy wagon take too much damage or you'll have to start again.
Okay, great.
Our journey begins. Epic, heroic, daring, valiant, courageous!
SpongeBob, you're driving a sandwich.
I love sandwiches!
Not just a sandwich, a Krabby Patty.
With cheese!
We didn't forget the cheese this time! Yes! Okay, so... in the next episode, we'll drive the paddy wagon, which is actually a pretty cool concept. But we'll learn very quickly how enraging it can be. Next episode is gonna probably be well. I'm not gonna say anything this year. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.